actually, to be honest with you, when I first started music, I was like 13 years old, man, 12, man. I mean, you know what I mean? And it was a group, not a through street. And I had a family member who was a part of that group. And, you know, it had a lot of street buzz, a lot of street hype behind that group. And I said my first rap that I ever wrote, I said to a guy named Olympus. And he really liked it, and that meant a lot to me, man. That's what struck that fire, man. You got what you got now. You know what I mean? It was a while back when I got started rapping. Black Market was the first label I ever signed to.
You ever, do you remember your first rap?
Oh yeah, man.
What is it?
Oh man, you would think that I wrote the rap about something. I was like, once knew a nigga named Aaron Wood, tried to put it down, tried to claim the hood. And this is how I found out Eric was a punk, late night in the streets. Laying in the cut, ready to dump on them niggas from the other side. And when we got out, I saw a tear drop from his eye. We started busting and he didn't reach for a strap. He got caught once and twice in the back. So we jumps in the ride. I wonder if he lived or died. Another victim of a drive-by. Now this is for my homies who ain't here no more. And it goes on. You know what I mean? That was my first rap, man, on real. That was my first rap. I wrote that rap and Lyrical V. Lyrical Vivian, man, that boy, man, hey, I'm telling you. He went over it with me, and I bust that for Relentless, and when he liked it, that was like one of the happiest moments of my life, man. And that's what really started it. I went behind the scenes every day after school. I'm on it. From Centennial High School, I'm walking home with the homies from school. High-powered dudes, man, it's in jail with life right now, not coming home. I'm walking with the homies, walking down the ramp, coming from the bus stop, rapping to him. That was just me. It just lit that fire, man. You know what I mean? So I've been real dedicated with this, man. My first deal went with Black Market. Me and a part of mine, Revenge, we looked on the back of the Brother Lynch CD, and it had the address. Why did they have a motherfucking address on the back of it, man? We gassed up a 280Z, that was my car. I had an exhaust leak and all that. We drove all the way to Sacramento. We saved our bread up, drove all the way to Sacramento. I was a Piru and he was a Crip. So what we did was we went to Garden Block, Sebo neighborhood. A whole bunch of Crips hanging on the corner hollering at each other. He jumped out. Check this out, I'm a Compton Crip. I want to bust a rap, and I'm trying to meet Sebo. He got off, and then they was like, Looney Coney, he don't live. So when I roll up on the Bloods from Oak Park or Meadowview or wherever we was at, when it was Bloods, I jump out. I'm a Crewtown Five, man, hold on, I want to bust my rap. I'm trying to meet Sebo, Brother Lynch, Black Market, where Black Market? Man, they got us right there. The first time we went, we didn't have no luck, but we was learning the town. The second time we went, went straight to Black Market. That's when we met Bad Credit, Cape Fire the Natural, and all these other cats, Triple Beam, you know, all the other dudes that were down there at that time, man. Third time was when we met Sid. You know what I mean? Fourth time we went down there, it was Contract, it was Sit Downs, it was Quincy, it was Illusion, it was a band full of us from LA, man, really trying to get on, man. So when I say hard work pays off, it was a lot of hard work, man. A lot of money was being saved up to make them trips. We did that out of our own pocket. We didn't have no help. No, I took money provide for my family and doing what I was doing to go towards that because that was my dream to make it come true. And I look at it now, man, guess what? Bandana's on Black Market Records, man. Really finna push it though. If they just mind their own business, they can have a business. You feel me? Man, you know, right now it ain't no, you know, we don't have no alliance or none of that type of stuff, man. I don't, you know, deal with dude, man, he's doing his thing, I do my thing, man. I didn't get compensated for a lot of stuff that I did, man, for that dude, man. I brought them dudes down to Compton, man, and you know what I mean, and helped dude out, man, just based on him saying he was from a neighborhood that was connected to my neighborhood, and I did a lot of real things, man, and wasn't compensated for it, man. And I seen the movement was more movement towards funk and not movement towards music. I'm getting into it with a lot of good dudes, the Speak Dirties and all these other dudes are real good dudes, you know what I mean, and I ain't feeling that, you feel me? I'm not feeling that, man. I mean, you know, I'm on a real movement, man. I'm on a peace movement, man. I mean, you know, I'm with our people sticking together. I'm not with a movement that's gonna destroy our people. You feel me? Straight up. So, you know what I mean? Pay your people. If you're with them and they do stuff for you, man, pay your people, man. That's period, point blank. That's all you gotta do, man. And be real with yourself. Cause I'm real with myself. When I look in the mirror, I'm Bandana the Ragg, man, a black man, man, that's trying to arise out of all this chaos. When you look in the mirror, you should understand who you really are, man. And be 100 with the opposite to deal with you. And that's just it, man. Straight up.